God, it was like crushing him, but it was like so great. And it was not anything like what I do, but I'm such a, I have wanderlust when it comes to comics. I mean, I have Mouse, and that's, I love Mouse. And yeah. It's like, oh, Alex, sure. And Art Spiegelman, and Raw, and all that stuff. And I was like, that's not, I don't draw anything like that. I don't like anything like that. Well, I respect that stuff so much.
I'll admit, you know, again, I don't know a lot, but you don't have to look very, take very long to look and see the broad variety of graphic novels that are there, which is, I think it's fantastic. Any kind of drawing style, any kind of writing style or whatever seems to be able to find a place and home in graphic novels, which is great. Like I said, democratization, if you will.
Yeah. A lot of really sort of interesting, eclectic things to say, and it's not necessarily, and yet now they can say it, you know. And sometimes really beautiful in ways that would have never been available to them 20 years ago. Yeah. Because technology didn't let them have that voice, you know.
I also want to say that, especially Japan, Japanese graphic novel and comic industry is on the shelf, especially in comparison to the US. Like, I think sales for one piece can be like $1 completely eclipse all of North American comic books. And with France and Belgium also, like, comics are a large part of the culture. They're things that are like, they're respected and a larger part of the culture of this person. And so it makes sense that like, there's a lot of really good things like that. That's like, you have a lot of really excellent comics, like, you know, all the superhero comic genre, which is pretty much like motion centered in the United States. But there's also a lot of really excellent things.
Do you have Steve's work up in there?
Yeah, is this the first one? Okay. Yeah, this is sort of like, this is what I'm doing now, and I work with a lot of animators who come over to features, so they kind of do these 11 panels per side, so it's like 22 frames on a kind of quick feature stack up. And this is just a scene from Oblivion where Jack, his character, wakes up and he's sort of in chains, and then there's sort of this figure in the darkness that he can't see, that he can hear, and then he strikes his cigar and it just lights it, and it, the whole image is just sort of like, it's just black, it's extremely graphic, and it just lends itself to,
Can you get rid of it?